Previous videos, I've been asked to sort of explain how I've made one of the shapes, and I just thought it would be a really good opportunity to show you how I've done that, because I didn't show you it in the video, and yeah, just show you sort of how easy it is. It's mainly going to be done using either a shape builder tool or the sort of the Pathfinder tools. With a little bit of other stuff in there. Now you can do it quite easily in the CC versions of Adobe Illustrator, but the person that's asked for it has specifically asked for sort of how would they do that in CS6, and I'm going to try and sort of fumble my way through it through kind of remembering what I used to do back then, but let's see. I'll show you a few different techniques of how to get that shape. They're all super easy, but obviously with anything like this, it's only easy if you know the techniques. So let's get into it. Right, we're in Illustrator, and this is the logo that we're trying to recreate, that hexagonal shape, that sort of star shape. Basically, it was just asked how is that made in CS6. So I'll show you how to make it in CS6, and I'll also show you how you can make it in the latest version of CC as well. So let's just copy that out of there so we know what we're looking at, and make it a little bit bigger. So this shape is made up of three oblongs with a slight bulbous middle as well. So let's just start with an oblong or a rectangle, whatever you want to call it, and then I'm just going to add a couple of nodes in there, pull these out, and then with this selected, so this would be the CS6 version. From what I can remember, this is how it would have been done in CS6. So you would select it, and we're going to click transform and rotate. So because this is made out of three and we want it to turn within a circle, which is 360 degrees, we need to divide it by three. So that's 120 degrees. So you just type in your 120 degrees into there, make sure that you've got preview on, and then just click copy. And we're going to do that one more time, and that's our basic shape. Now all we need to do is join them together. We do that using the Pathfinder tool under Unite, and then using Effect, Stylize, and Round Corners. If you type in probably either 3 or 4, let's just go for 4. And there you go. It's as simple as that. So that's the CS6 version. What we can do is, let's undo that. If we were to do it sort of CC way of doing it, you can do it exactly how I've done it there, obviously. Or you can still Pathfinder tool, or even Shape Builder tool. And all you do with the Shape Builder tool is select everything within that shape, or within your selected shapes. You can either do Effect, Round Corners again, or using your Direct Select tool, select all the nodes, and now what you can do is bring those edges in, or bring those corners in even, and that'll give you another rounded shape. The nice thing about this tool is that you can just select specific nodes and shape them, which then means that you can make these a little bit more dramatic on the round corners, and then the inner stuff you can make less dramatic, so it gives it a little bit more balance. So there you are, it's literally that simple. A really quick tutorial, but these techniques are going to help you so much if you don't already know them. I use these techniques in every logo design, every logo type design as well. So yeah, if it has been helpful, let me know in the comments below. If you liked the video, why not give it a like? And if you want to see more, you should probably click subscribe. So that's it for now. Thanks again, and I'll see you in the next one.